In 1966, there was a Festschrift volume prepared for my teacher, Viki Weisskopf. And as usual, I procrastinated and didn't write my piece and didn't know what to write and didn't feel like writing and so on. And finally, the volume appeared without anything from me. And I was so ashamed of not having contributed to this volume in honor of Viki that I didn't read it. But in it was an article by Yoichiro Nambu, or Nambu Yoichiro, a very good friend of mine, whom I'd known for years and years. He was my first visitor to come to Caltech to see me when I first arrived at Caltech. And and Yoichiro was pursuing some work that he had done with a man named Han, the Han-Nambu picture. And what they had done was to suggest that there were actually three quarks, three U quarks, three D quarks, and three S quarks. And that the charges were not two-thirds, minus a third, and minus a third, but the integral charges, which when averaged over this new three-valued variable, would give two-thirds, minus a third, and minus a third. So from the point of view of later work, what they were doing was introducing the color variable with a terrible mistake, namely that there was a color term in the electric current, in the charge operator or the electric current operator. Well, the first was correct, the second was wrong. He then suggested that these particles were real, that they could actually come out and be seen, but that they would be largely confined. They would be difficult to get out because there would be a potential between them which would strongly favor the states that were actually seen. By this time, people had proposed a very crude SU6 symmetry scheme, which involved both the SU3 variable and the spin. And this was quite useful for classification purposes. It gave rise to a 56 representation, which included the octet of spin 1/2 and the decimet of spin 3/2. And let's see, what else? That's 48. There must have been another octet and a singlet. No, just another octet, I guess. No, wait a minute. No, that's right. No, it's correct. No, 56 is just those two. Just those two. It's an octet of spin 1/2, which is 16, and 8 times 2, and then a decimet of spin 3/2, which is 40, and 40 and 16 is 56. Sorry, I got mixed up. Anyway, they would form a single multiplet under this combined spin and SU3 group, SU6. And that was what we needed, because that was what we saw.